I'm Stefan Bauman. Welcome to The Grand View. America's national parks through the eyes of an artist. We were, this painting last week got into a lot of back and forth, and Judy brought it back in today, and she said, so is this what you wanted? And so she went and she highlighted, you know, a couple of things, and then...
adding darks and lights and shadows and trying to do everything that you were saying to them, but it was still flat.
It was still flat. So then what did I do?
The white, just bend it.
So what I did was I just put in that little bit of light right there. Yeah, and I just... like, that's it. See?
Amazing.
Boom. I just took brilliant yellow light right out of the tube, took her brush. Now, I don't like to work on students' work.
He asked permission.
I asked permission. I don't like working on Judy's work. You know, over the years, I have a lot. But Judy has developed a nice, refined, careful style. And when I walk on her painting, it's like I have big, muddy boots. And so we have this understanding that I will point what to do, but you know, it's always like I have to do it. But she was at a stop, absolute stop. And I said, okay, are you ready to like see? Because she was like, well, why does everything have to be glazed? And I said, well, they don't. We can just put some light in. And she says, but I have light on the spools and the spindles. And the thing that I wanted to get ultimately at is that, yes, you did increase the light on the spools and the spindles, but at that point, what are we doing? We're emphasizing things, right?
Well, I was doing shadows, trying to create the light effect.
Yeah, but it wasn't, even the shadow, cast shadows weren't strong enough that really jumped. So I said, can I sit down? Are you? She says, reluctantly, yes. And so all I did was take brilliant yellow light right out of the tube, and I put it there and there. And I just stood back and I said, see? That's an effect. Now we have shadows from the spindles. We have a directed light center focal point. You know where the viewer is supposed to look. I said, that's it. Taking ordinary to extraordinary only takes a few little dashes and dots. You know, Mimi always says it's like the master's touch. But the thing is, I don't keep it secret.
That's true.
There are actually artists that teach portraiture, and they will never show how to do eyes. Because as long as the students don't know how to do eyes, they'll be in their class. Can you believe that? There are artists that will never explain how to bring that spark into your painting. I do it every week. This stuff is the magic. Isn't that right?
Absolutely.
How many classes, how many workshops have you gone to?
Many, many, many.
Yeah.
But none have given me the tools that you've given me in a short time.
Yeah, in a matter of a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know, he's bringing paintings in that, and I'm like going, so what do you think of this? I'm going, yeah, and he's like, what do you mean? This is like, and I go, nope. And we pound, and it's like, what did your wife think of that painting when you brought it? And how long did it take to put that in?
Yeah, not that long.
Just a few seconds.
Effects.
Mm-hmm.
Bring out.
Yeah.
It's just turns of a painting into a piece of art.
Yes.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
It's just amazing.
Yeah, this is, and you guys, it's...
We know that.
Yeah. And the rest of it is practice. But you can see it's not that easy because we have a crowd of people. And every once in a while, you guys get it.